HyPrSpace, short for Hybrid Propulsion for Space, is a French space startup founded in 2019. The company is developing a micro-launch vehicle powered by hybrid rocket engines, setting itself apart in a field where many startups opt for liquid propellant engines. German startup HyImpulse also embraces hybrid propulsion, highlighting the growing appeal of this technology. HyPrSpace focuses on the micro-launcher market, designing vehicles capable of delivering up to 250 kilos to orbit, less than half the payload capacity of Rocket Lab's Electron rocket. Despite the smaller scale, European governments and space agencies will likely prioritize local providers, creating a strong market for such payloads in Europe. HyPrSpace submitted a proposal for the European Launcher Challenge. If selected, the company could secure up to €169 million from the European Space Agency. The competition is fierce, with 12 proposals submitted, so we'll just have to wait to see which companies were selected. In just 5 years, HyPrSpace has raised €39.82 million through seed funding and contracts, employing over 90 people, and is continuing to expand. The French space agency, CNES, recognized its potential, selecting HyPrSpace as one of four companies in a €400 million program to strengthen domestic micro-launcher startups. HyPrSpace is targeting commercial, government, and defense clients, positioning itself as a key player in Europe's space sector. HyPrSpace adopts a pragmatic test-and-learn approach to rocket development, as outlined on their website. No lengthy simulations, excessive paperwork, and rigid decision-making. They embrace simplicity as a core mantra. This agile methodology accelerates progress, enabling HyPrSpace to compete in the fast-evolving commercial space landscape. Technology. HyPrSpace is developing a scalable hybrid rocket engine that blends the simplicity of solid propulsion with the performance of liquid propulsion, delivering a reliable and cost-effective solution for space access. Hybrid rocket engines combine a solid fuel grain, such as high-density polyethylene, or HDPE for short, with a liquid oxidizer, typically liquid oxygen. Liquid engines offer thrust modulation and high performance, but are complex and costly to develop. Solid engines are simple and affordable, but lack control and efficiency. HyPrSpace's hybrid design bridges this gap, enabling thrust modulation and reignition while maintaining simplicity. HyPrSpace's patented architecture features a thin, annular combustion chamber that optimizes combustion efficiency. Instead of complex turbopumps, HyPrSpace uses a high-pressure helium gas to feed the oxidizer into the engine, eliminating approximately 30 parts compared to traditional liquid engines. This pressure-fed system reduces weight, complexity, and failure risks, potentially cutting costs by up to 40%. The use of solid HDPE fuel improves safety, as it remains inert without an igniter, eliminating the risk of spontaneous explosions, common in liquid propellant systems. For example, SpaceX's Ship 36 test failure in June 2025 and Rocket Factory Augsburg's August 2024 explosion due to a turbopump oxygen fire highlight the risk of liquid engines. HyPrSpace's design avoids such failure points, protecting ground infrastructure and improving reliability. Additionally, HDPE is non-toxic and can be sourced from recycled materials, making HyPrSpace's engines eco-friendly. Simplified handling and logistics further streamline launch operations. While hybrid engines may have slightly lower specific impulse, ISP is estimated at 260 to 280 seconds in vacuum, compared to liquid engines, HyPrSpace prioritizes safety, simplicity, and cost efficiency. This trade-off suits their micro-launcher market, targeting 200 to 250 kilo payloads to low Earth orbit. By reducing complexity and improving safety, HyPrSpace's hybrid technology offers Europe a competitive, sovereign solution for affordable and sustainable space access. HyPrSpace's suborbital and orbital rockets. HyPrSpace is developing a micro-launcher system comprising the suborbital Baguette 1 and the orbital Baguette 1, or OB1. Powered by their hybrid propulsion engines. Both vehicles are part of the Agile Space Access Development Project, or PADA 1, funded with €35 million under France's 2030 Mini and Micro Launcher Initiative. PADA 1 and Consortium. HyPrSpace leads a consortium with CT Engineering and Telespazio France to finalize OB-1's design and conduct Baguette 1's first flight in Q1 2026. The PADA-1 project aims to ensure sovereign sustainable access to space for small satellites, innovate with greener, cost-competitive propulsion technologies, and improve France's leadership in the mini and micro launcher sector. Baguette 1 Suborbital Demonstrator. Baguette 1, a 7 to 10 meter tall suborbital rocket, will validate HyPrSpace's hybrid propulsion system in flight, scheduled for launch in Q1 2026 from a French DGA site. This demonstrator can carry up to 300 kilos, paving the way for orbital missions. OB-1 Orbital Baguette 1. OB-1, a 16-meter-tall micro-launcher, is designed to deliver 200 to 250 kilos to low Earth orbit by 2027. Under the R2-D2 contract with the French Space Agency, HyPrSpace will provide 5 launches for payloads up to 235 kilos. This contract supports France's strategic goal of autonomous, responsive access to space, similar to the US Space Force's tactically responsive missions. HyPrSpace successfully completes 2 engine test campaigns at DGA in Gironde, France. The goal of these Terminator engine tests was to verify that the hybrid propulsion system performs in line with theoretical models. These successful campaigns also proved the engine worked at full scale, reliably, and with the expected performance. During the campaigns, the engines were fired at varying thrust levels, using an incremental test-and-learn approach. These test campaigns also provided critical hands-on experience in operating an engine using cryogenic propellants. There is a learning curve in handling cryogenic propellants that needs to be mastered before the first flight of Baguette 1 next year. A third test campaign is in preparation, with new parameters to further refine the system. Future tests will integrate a LOX tank and a thrust vector control system, simulating flight conditions to ensure readiness for the 2026 suborbital launch and the 2027 orbital mission. Baguette 1 demonstrator will launch from France. HyPrSpace will launch their suborbital demonstrator from a missile testing site in southern France, following an agreement signed with the French Defence Procurement Agency, or DGA, in June 2025. Baguette 1, a 10-meter single-stage vehicle, can carry up to 300 kilos to suborbital space. It will validate key hybrid propulsion technologies in flight, paving the way for HyPrSpace's orbital rocket targeted for 2027. The DGA site, already used for HyPrSpace's static fire test campaigns, is a natural choice for the Q1 2026 launch, leveraging existing infrastructure and expertise. Upcoming events. The suborbital test launch is scheduled for 2026, and as just discussed, will fly from mainland France. The orbital launch vehicle is expected to fly in 2027, although that depends on a range of factors, including the success or failure of their suborbital flight. For orbital missions, potential sites include the ESA spaceport in French Guiana, S-Range Space Center in Sweden, or sea-based platforms. What are your thoughts on their rocket technology? Are hybrid launchers competitive in the commercial market? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you will see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.